fancy, huh?
Ooh.
That's all pitch.
That was all.
Howdy, kids. This here's King Kukulele with a little health and safety tip for you. Now, remember, kids, if you're going out to the ocean after a rainstorm, remember to wait 48 hours, and I'll tell you why. Well, I don't like poop, that's no lie, because when I eat poop, I catch E. coli.
And E. coli just ain't no fun, no, I don't like poop.
Well, I won't drink pee, that's just me. I'd rather have an ounce of iced tea. Now, I think you'll still the sea with pee-pee, and I don't like pee.
Hello, everybody. My name is Cedric.
And you're new. It's me, King Kukulele. I'm
on the screen.
Ow!
You're
much younger than that. Huh? A what? I'm not a kid. What is an id? Does anybody know what an id is out there?
What is an id?
Oh, I'm in. Oh.
You're my id.
You better watch it or else I'm on it.
What?
You never remember the words. You guys have fun, but don't forget I'm in here, okay? Come visit me sometime. I get lonely inside here.
So long, King Koo.
King Koo.
For anybody that doesn't speak that Japanese language, Nihongo, that means he is a banana.
He is a banana.
I am only like an image projected through the ether. And for those of you that are in front of the camera, that's what it looks like from my point of view.
They're saying they're watching a baby on a screen drool gallons of spittle.
Yeah.
What do you think that's? Do you think they like that?
They love it.
You call that insulting the intelligence of the audience, right?
They love
it. More than a baby. You're more than a baby. She's once.
Twice. Three. Your baby was hurt during the making of this film.
What?
What? Get ready for it, folks. Get your dancing shoes on.
Get that bugger!
Ah!
My finger!
We love you, Booger Patrol. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Booger Patrol. My baby bites you. That makes us blue. Yeah. Look at a booger! Get that booger.
Yay!
I'm the guy you always talk to when you meet.
You're my it,
before
right?
Before you go up here to do a show,
my
you start talking to yourself. That's me.
Yeah, I get nervous before shows.
I'm the one that has to listen to all that.
Sorry. Well, what are you?
I know everything about your childhood. I remember it all.
You lived it, right?
Here, I'll test you. I'll say one word.
Okay.
And you tell me what it means.
Okay.
Suicide.
It's a drink with everything mixed together in
right.
It. Like every drink.
Right.
That was supposed to be cut out.
Baby. Rocking your cradle like waves on the sea.
Rock. Okay, fine.
Fantastic.
Sharkicky. So, here we are.
And when I got to the hospital, they looked at me and it looked like I had a big shark hickey on my stomach. They were all kind of laughing.
That's got
to be. And I still, to this day, have a little minor scar.
From a shark.
When I'm alone and I think of the life I missed out on, I know it doesn't help to be away from you long. Together we'll make a song. Your music can never be wrong.
The end.
Oh.
Wow. Work in progress.
Oh, not yet. Oh, no.
Beated Raleigh's, take some fries over to Solly's, paid off, used to golf, play tennis, and I ain't finishing your sandwich. Dual personalities fighting in my head, what plays out flows through this pen. I met you at a warehouse, said me and some people were coming out with a movie. Had you looking like, yeah, Bruni, right, but we went out one night, I was coming for you, but not Crazy Eyes Killer. It was chilly, the 21st of December. Shape up our soul bodies, floating like infinity, astrophysically, stars like space, feel like Walter, memory erased like the dust falling to the floor of your mind, embedded in you but consciously missing like a hole through black time, move slower, systematically moving at random and contradicting self, meaning has me gaining fandom, vulnerable to attack, watch my back, we're going undercover, burning rubber, deep slumber, noise impact, smell the pollution, time not intact, linear becomes abstract, I watch myself react through my third eye, my ancestors survived and thrived, I've lived a billion lives. I have unlocked the mysteries of the future and the past. I have turned time into ash and I am existing in the sixth dimension. I can maneuver through the past and the future like an unwinded state, like I was a centurion on a date, eating a frosted flake. Oh no, sugar transmits the energy sphere that takes time to unwind, like a mind gift was expanding, like a time was enhanced, like I was entranced, like a rose petal. I handed it to you and it's on your fingertips and you lick your lips. My actions signify why the man in the mirror appears, and tears form like a bookworm, whole found like a puzzle piece, Risa mocking a serendipitous, infectious, dubious, superstitious meaning, feeling like a meal with a king whose arm rests in a sling after a snowboard fiasco. Muddy Waters once said, you can't miss what you've never had, and I've never had a popsicle on a motorcycle with cargo, with Pablo going farther on a Vespa, going faster is a disaster that lasts as long as endless hallways with doors, but no numbers I found. The slumber lumber jumper, slats, stats, the year of the last bod, rap, clap, map, jack, rhinestone, heartless, farther than Jay's bird nest, lest you remember last September in your imagination station. I dig your contemplation and get down with your witness anatomical forgiveness.
I think it's very interesting that you bring that up. The truth, that's been a big, it's been very prevalent in my life.
Does the brain more detect consciousness or create consciousness? Does the heart, soul, and mind create it, or is it there and we're just detecting it?
Can be both. In different ways, as opposites.
Opposites, what a great word. So that's what we're talking about, like...
And can be both, and simultaneously, and can be the other in the same time. Who knows?
Simultaneously. You answered a question with a question. That's what we're all about. Who knows?
I usually tell the truth, and that's in my name, too. Yeah. My Hungarian name is Vera, and that is truth. And
that
faith.
Means truth?
Yes.
Oh.
Vera, Verita, Vera.
V-E-R-A?
Yeah, V-E-R-A.
Oh my
God. That's truth.
Boy, you are.
So I speak the truth. I have nothing to hide.
You have to.
Basically.
Are we actually giving birth to consciousness?
I would say it's about 50-50 of detecting consciousness and consciousness being there. It's kind of like when your mom, you know, when you're young age, your mom tells you don't put your hand on that stove, but you're a little kid. You're going to rebel. Something in your mind's going to say, go ahead, do it. Go ahead, rebel against your mom. Go ahead, pitch your hand on the stove. You know it's hot. Go ahead and do it. And you get burned. Then she tell you again, don't pitch your other hand on the other side of the stove. And then you're going to pitch your other hand on the side of the stove just because your conscience, once again, it tells you, go ahead, pitch your hand there. Rebel against your mom.
And that was like the premise of what our workshop was about, finding the truth. Just the truth. The truth about myself, the truth about characters.
Yeah.
Just seeking the truth to bear... You know, to be not maybe totally transparent, but to be just have a good understanding and to be able to express in a way that can be very clear and easy to receive rather than trying to force some maybe bullshit on people, right? It's, you know, rather let's seek the truth.
So we're talking about motherhood and birth. Do we birth consciousness or is it already there and we're just detecting it?
It was already there, but we still, I mean, we're still searching to find it.
We're still searching,
searching to find it. There are some that has it, and they don't know how to do with it, what to do with it, and they just already are seeking for it, still can't find it.
Alice Walker says, yes, Mother, I can see you are flawed. You have not hidden it. That is your greatest gift to me. Wow. What does that mean to you?
Wow, just truth. You know, that's another being who you are. Everybody has something to offer.
Yeah.
Your flaws are just as important as what
as your strength.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because you learn more in the valley experiences. That's where your character is developed.
Yeah.
Man is in an ignorant state, as sinus in his own fate. So I think that will address it more direct to the point.
The three is homeless.
The truth is homeless?
Yes.
I haven't heard that one, but I know Louis
Buñuel.
I'm going to look that up. I like that. But Louis Buñuel said a good one that I often think about. I'm for anyone who seeks the truth, but I part ways when they claim they found it.
I'm so sad Maya's going off to college.
It's okay.
I'm gonna miss you. Before you go to college, I want to give
you
a present.
We're gonna miss you, Maya. We want to give you a present, okay?
You can have my car as your college present, Maya.
I'm gonna miss you. You write to us, okay?
Maya, don't you even say goodbye?
It seems like it was only yesterday that we taught her how to drive a car. Now we don't even have any transportation. How are we going to even go and visit her? I'm so sad, Bernie. She's gone off to college.
It's okay. It's okay.
It seems like only yesterday that Maya learned how to put the dishes away from the dishwasher.
Seems like only yesterday that I was teaching her how to cook.
Put the egg in the pot.
Yeah, you taught her how to cook. She was such a good chef. She was always making those hard-boiled eggs. Now I don't even know what I'm gonna eat without her. She was always making my food for me.
You hear stories of, you know, roommates, they, eat past certain time, and you know, it could lead to diabetes.
And I don't know if she's gonna be able to get along with her roommate. She's always had trouble sharing.
What are you doing?
Think she's gonna do all her homework, or she's gonna lose it to booze and liquor?
I just hope she doesn't, you know, get into alcohol or drugs or psychedelics like mushrooms, acid, DMT, ayahuasca, peyote.
What are you talking about?
I mean, if she does do ayahuasca, you know, I may want to have some.
Why would she give it to you?
But not, you know, not with her.
No, she's not gonna share ayahuasca with you. Are you nuts?
But I mean, you know, she's of age and, you know, it's an ancient ceremony.
Why would she take ayahuasca?
Will you experience what death is like and...
That doesn't make any sense.
You know, I don't see anything wrong with it. I mean...
Bruni!
But, you know, I am worried about her.
This is our daughter we're talking about. We raised her all 14 months of her life.
I don't know what's gonna come of her. I don't know what her life is gonna be like. I don't know where she's gonna be at night. I feel like lost. I feel like my life doesn't have purpose anymore. I miss her so much.
She better go off to become a famous singer and not forget about us. We're banking on her becoming rich and famous. There she is!
Maya, she's back!
What was wrong, Maya? Wait, she just wants some money. That's all you want, Maya?
Maya, we don't have any money.
I gave you all my money.
Maya, there isn't any money left.
There's
we
no
spent
money
it all.
In there, Maya.
Ayahuasca, 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 mamaycuna.
Had to be Colma, where San Francisco buries its dead. More people underground out here than above it. Guess that should have been a clue. In this business, it's easy to mess up, easy to take the wrong case.
I'm Josh Ellison, PI. You Patty? Madam Patty, I guess?
Mr. Ellison, please come closer.
Look, what's this all about, lady? You won't say Jack on the phone. When people abuse the free consultation, I...
My name is Howard Reardon.
That doesn't sound right.
I was murdered 80 years ago by my partner, Emmett Copperstein.
Okay.
I am speaking for this woman because she can commune with my kind. I seek justice. Without it, I cannot move on.
Bummer. Why do you off you?
I had a once-in-a-lifetime idea, pocket mints. With the aroma of fresh quims, so that your friends won't know how pitifully alone you are.
Holy shit. Cooter tax?
One of the ubiquitous little tabs was dissolving on my tongue now.
Copperstein was my friend, and he killed me for my idea. Threw me off the Stockton Tunnel Bridge in front of a trolley.
I think I get it. Retribution. Any idea where this copper fuck is living nowadays?
He's not. He's on my side. He haunts me still. You must come over here and banish him.
What the gack? I work in Liveland, buddy. It might suck, but I'm not taking the trip early for the likes of you.
He's gone.
Wait, what?
Mr. Ellison, you don't have to die. You must astral project. Then you can walk to the other side and fulfill your assignment.
I needed a drink. Luckily, I knew a place nearby. Even if I swore I'd never go back in there, these were extenuating circumstances.
Well, look who the fuck's here.
Shit.
Counselor? Counselor?
Doctor? Doctor?
Don't any of you ever go to court?
Not if we can help it. Come on, Joshy, take a seat, have a pint. Maybe we could bill it. Got something you might be able to help me out with.
No thanks, Anna. I'm looking elsewhere for jobs these days.
Come on, Ellison. Ain't there some other poor dickhead whose marriage you can destroy?
Jesus, Terry's still on about that?
I don't take divorce business anymore. Make it a shot, I won't be staying.
I know you fucked her. I know it was you on that tape. You ruined my life!
You suspected she was unfaithful?
Forget about him, Joshy. What you working on these days? Anyone who needs an attorney?
It's too late for the law on this one.
The most dangerous tool in a PI's arsenal is a valid library card.
I'm gonna go to the
Night noises. Never sleep through them. Usually I pass right back out. But seeing as how I'm half whacked anyway, maybe.
Who the fuck are you?
Me? Oh, this is so exciting. You can see me?
And feel you? What the hell?
Oh, blessed night. My lover and I are introduced. Ever since my husband passed in my firm embrace, by falling across my face and suffocating me in this very room, I've appreciated the coming of handsome young men into my home. Oh, look, sweetie. He can see us.
What?
Hey.
Ah! Oh,
there you go.
What dreams are bullshit?
I felt bad for leaving my body behind to get molested by Haints, but I had to get out of there. I can see them.
I've got to get to Stockton Tunnel. I wonder how fast I can move.
Copperman? Steen? Copperstein? Fucking Jew thief. That's right. Takes one to know one.
Here's a tip if you ever go astral. The farther you get from your body, the more you act like a drunken loon.
Suckling up that pour. Step out. I know you're here. Where it all went down. Didn't it? Hey!
You're making a fool of yourself. Sit down.
You copper semen?
I was.
I don't like you. You killed that poor ghost, took his idea.
Whose?
Reardon.
Reardon? Never heard of him. I didn't kill anybody. Nah, it was me that was killed. Killed right here. Pushed in front of a trolley by my own brother. I deserved it. I'd had his wife. I'd do it again. She was a choice piece. Keep hoping I'll find her on this side.
Doesn't make sense!
Joshy!
Doctor?
Pull up a stool.
Gosh.
I had to get a hold of myself. The part of myself that wasn't back in bed with my new rapist roommates. I needed to interrogate someone. I was a fucking PI, for Christ's sakes.
Oh, yeah, it's me. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's working real nice.
Yes, of course. Touch of local history for the flavor. And for another 500, I can extend the wild duck hunt. He's more gullible than I expected. Didn't you say he was a detective?
Bunglicker. But which one?
Hello.
Jesus!
Jesus, they're everywhere.
You can hear me. That is unexpected.
You didn't expect me to hear you. Why'd you say hi?
Habits do not die so easily as people.
You know this guy?
And I remember you as well. You came a few times for the woman. I enjoyed watching.
Are all ghosts fucking pervs?
The woman left. First the man was sad, then angry. Most hours he's inebriated, the rest he schemes. His hate nourishes me. I'm the strongest I've been in decades. It's nice talking with someone. This makes us friends.
Sure, thanks.
Would you like me to harm the little man? I would do that for a friend. It would be a pleasure.
No. Leave him be.
As you wish, friend.
Crowded train for this hour.
Raise your hand if you're a living human being. I'm Josh Ellison, PI. I bet some of you could use my help. Now, which of you ghouls left behind a big estate?
You can't have your cake and eat it too. You can't have the butter and the money. You can't drink the soup and keep your mustache dry. You can't have bear's paw and fish.
I'm Joe, the limo driver. I'm here to tell you the story of me, Bill, and Dave. The night I drove Dave Crosby. I'm Joey Icon.
As I look at my reflection in the broken fractured mirror, I
began to cry. A Cupid's tear.
Thought I was climbing the ladder of your love. Then you went and left me so flat. Hey, what's up with that?
He went in the bucket.
Bucket
in the bucket. Fucking throw it in the bucket, man. Yeah. Is that
like a cup
for a fuck bucket? Yeah. This goes out to a band from Germany.
Rammstein.
Rammstein. No, Rammstein. Yeah, get it right.
Get it right, you fucking ice horse.
You fucking ice horse.
Fucking bastards.
What do you want for dinner?
Spiders.
It tastes like pig livers.
Spiders.
It's really good. I don't know your hood. Some beer. It tastes good around here.
Schweinhaux!
I watched as shards of glass poked into his eyes, dripping the lies he never told, but lived from the inside out. Haunted, haunted from ghosts that never leave him alone. After he's committed the crime of deceiving innocence into his corrupt web, this web circumnavigates around his entirety, becoming a magnet for the bats and creatures of the great holy hole, the black hole, sucking, creeping, devouring its host until he has no other option but to strip naked, surrendered, and bare upon the soul of Earth. Heart open, nails digging into dirt, begging and pleading for God to redeem him from his sinister ways. The worst part is I can still hear his screams at night coming from the little boy inside of him, crying for mommy. How does one heal from something like this? They take the demon and transmute it by strapping a leash around its neck. I dominate the demon and make it work for me, instead of perpetually falling prey to his tricks.
stop.
There will be very difficult times ahead. When you realize this, will it be too late? Will it be too late?
A view from the mountain.
Took the spiritual name Solomon because I was taken up. I was what they call abducted. I was taken to this place. I was above the earth. They let me know that if I ask a question in my head, that they would give me the answer. We have to acknowledge the things that hold us back from being what we are. We have to acknowledge the reality of what this war is doing and killing people, and we're getting the karma from it. If you jump over a cliff or violate the principles of certain physics, things are going to happen to you. So I believe evil is this. We have to evolve as a people to our greatest intelligence, which is whatever created us. We have to overcome, identify, and either tear down or rebuild and analyze our behavior. Look at the war. Look at all the war countries. See, it's not South Central. You got intelligent people who are out here shooting and killing their brothers and sisters in the world. And these people are educated. They've been to schools. So it's really not a weakness once you're aware of your limitations. And then there's another power. So you're not really at a disadvantage. And you could have a weakness where maybe it's like a habit or something you do. I need to exercise more. I don't need to smoke more and all that. But if you really want to work on those, you could.
Yeah.
But that would be your weakness to choose to do it or not. So that those are the basic weaknesses, because we all want to be better people, yeah, and greater people. I'm going to try to be more tolerant. Everyone should try to be more tolerant with, yeah, your fellow human beings. Even if we don't agree, we got to try to be more nice, even though they're messing up the world. This earth is wired into us. And if we're living true and happy, it's like Mother Earth. It's going to protect us and make the atmosphere beautiful. But if we're killing, destroying, and oil polluting, it's going to turn on us, mm-hmm, you know. So if I acknowledge that, that's powerful because it's true. And in the beginning was the word. Words have power. Mm-hmm. The pen is mightier than the sword.
These snakes are like miracles. They bring miracles to me and other people, their images. And I wish y'all blessings.
So I heard that Venice is lined with Mecca, something there. That's why people pilgrimage there from all over the world. I remember my mother in Africa. It would be Africa because it seemed like a jungle. And then we were rowing on a river, but it was ancient times, and then we were being pursued by something. And I was a baby, and my mother was rowing on this river, trying to escape and protect me, but I was aware of it. And so all of a sudden, we appeared on Broadway.
Inside my mind's museum, there are relics of old jealousies refashioned into contemporary humilities. A handmade cradle for newborn heartbeats, a tiny spark of angel fire ready to justly combust into TNT dynamite. Inside my mind's museum, there are homes filled with ohms, dark hearses converted into low-riding living words of wisdoms, questions beasting for the deep-down blood taste of truth. Mondays feeling more like Sundays, cross-dressing as Fridays on a hot date Saturday night. Punk rock to polka, folk to funkadelic, John Bonham drums with a bass foot heavy as the infinity of outer space. Inside my mind's museum, there are subterranean homesick blues collaborating with inner city blues, writing a song about how we're gonna fight the power and rise, rise, rise. Tombstone anti-blisses transformed into technicolor kisses, dog-eared books and diamond dogs, symphonies and sympathies, a mildly depressed inner child suddenly winning at the game of the not at all trivial pursuit of happiness. Inside my mind's museum, there are hopes uncoiling lynching ropes into shoelaces of graces, a holy spirit you can pour over crushed ice and sip on a menacingly horrendous day. Inside my mind's museum, there's a voice that's a brass-knuckled fist in the face of malevolence, a voice that echoes the North Star and the safest way home, a voice that's an X marking the spot of promises refusing to break.
Need a date for Valentine's Day? All you need is some sugar. Let me show you.
Okay, it's called Mom because the word matriarchy or mafia is the topic. Matriarchy is what caused the mother or the woman as the head of the family. The word or, since words evoke more than their meaning, we mine in the dimension, the meaning of these words. Mafia starts with the letter M-A, which could refer to mother. The mafia is a closed group of people having controlling influences. So, the word mafia starts with the letters ma because women may run the world, but let men think they run the world. Coppola said, I wanted to use the mafia as a metaphor for America. Mother Earth, Mother Nature, Mother Tongue, giving birth to words. Guma, Mother Love, Mother Country. Mama is probably a natural sound. In baby talk, imitating the sound while sucking.
So, baby, you always ask me about this tattoo I got. People always ask me about it. But it's cool that you're asking me as my little munchkin. Well, the thing that I always say to people is that it's my way of grounding. It's my symbol of womanhood near the ground on my ankle as low as it could go. But really, really what it is that I was bored on a Sunday in college, and I was a doodler, and so I would just draw circles, and I needed something to do, and so I decided I would go and get a tattoo. It did hurt, yes, it hurt. Not that bad, it was kind of nice. I have to say, you shouldn't get a tattoo, but you can get them. It's okay. You can get them when you're big. But this was really, when I say it wasn't true that it was a symbol of womanhood, that's not entirely right either. It's my connection to my sisters, my beautiful sisters, your aunties, who have been so big in my life, you know. Auntie Ella, Auntie Hannah. And so, really, my womanhood is connected to these women, my sisters, my mom, my aunts, my grandma. This lineage of women that you're part of now. Lucky you. And you get to come after and see even more amazing women. This is the circle of women, and you're in it. Welcome, my love. Feeling myself today, let me tell you what. I feel like I could really use a little, I need a fresh hairdo, a little je ne sais quoi to really put some pep in my step. I'm tired and my throat's been through the ringer. Oh, well, at least I'll get a couple hours to sleep tonight.
I knew I would find something interesting in my backyard. What does this mean? Hey, so I found this weird paper that must lead somewhere. Wanna go look?
Oh, that'd be awesome. Great, yeah, I'll be there soon. Okay.
Do you wanna come look at a weird paper?
Okay, happy to. Be there soon.
I used to live. Different than
I remember
here
a place I used
ways.
To live.
I was on the fifth floor with an apartment.
I was on the fifth floor with an apartment. I lived across from a kind of park. It would fill with snow in the winter.
My living room
had that view from two blue windows or three.
And I had a bedroom with one.
And I had a bedroom with one. And in the window a fan for any season, even winter. I was there just recently, but not really, I think. Just somewhere like it. I remember seeing a house in the desert from there almost instantly, then back. The way I see the place I used to live now might be different than how I saw it then. I see that place in town in a wonderful blue, like mornings and nights. I remember one day they were being struck by information. I remember put together versions of that place that I passed without seeing 1 year ago and saw without passing it yesterday. If I went back, it would be a new version. It was where I was, and now I'm here, where I want to be.
1 year ago and saw without passing it yesterday. Welcome. I have food and a solvable mystery.
Those two of my favorite things.
It's great to be here. I guess we're like mystery explorers. I guess.
Now look, that is the paper.
Thank you.
good food here, and I have my guesses to the mystery paper.
I have ideas as well, but I disagree.
Great, then let's have a friendly debate.
This document is awesome. It's from the future, which is also awesome.
Your response? This is an important document, and those come from the past. So I reason that is its origin.
Wait, you're both wrong. It's from the present, and it tells us where to go.
Okay, yeah!
Fully understand. It says go out and explore and find what we're searching for.
We've never done that before. Can I look more closely at that document?
Okay, no problem.
Thank you.
The box of interest. I have found it first. This is cool and good. I will go to the house and open it.
So how do you make lentil soup?
I would boil some lentils and then I would put some olive oil somewhere else and fry up some other vegetables in it. And then I would cook it all together until it's cooked. And I might put in spices and things as well.
Cool.
I know what to do. I'll show you. First this, then this, then this, then that, then this, then that, then this.
All of our problems are solved! All of our problems are solved!
Let's go to the house and solve them.
That is good tea.
Thank you. I would like to purchase again of your finest hot dog water.
That way. Get your hot dog water that way.
I would like to purchase again of your finest hot dog water.
That way, get your hot dog water that way.
I would like to purchase again of your finest hot dog water.
Hot dog water! Who wants to buy hot dog water?
I would be refreshed by hot dog water.
Half a glass or full?
Full, please.
Go in there.
This is my box and you can't have it.
We should all look into it together. It's not just your box.
Yeah, we'll all look together.
Yes, it's all of ours, the box.
Come to the fine outside area.
We're almost there.
But where could the other half of the paper be? If we had it, we would know.
be awesome. All right, sound rolling. Action.
I remember a place I used to live, different from here in many ways. I was on the fifth floor with an apartment. I lived across from a kind of park. It would fill with snow in the winter. My living room had that view from two blue windows, or three. It changed. And I had a bedroom with one, and in the middle, a fan for any I can't do this. Okay. And I had a bedroom with one, and in the window, a fan for any season, even winter. I was there just recently, but not really, I think. Just somewhere like it. I remember seeing a house in the desert from there almost instantly, then back the way I see a place I used to live right now. Might be different from how I saw it then. I see that place in town in a wonderful blue, like mornings and nights. I remember one day there being stuck by information. I remember put together versions of that place that I passed without seeing 1 year ago and saw without passing it yesterday. If I went back, it would be a new version. It was where I was, and now I'm here, where I want to be. Well, that's not actually true. I'm sorry.
It's a monologue.
I know. I couldn't make it. Like,
it was good. I like
it. That was
it.
Great. That was
half the paper.
Very good to see.
I agree.
It all makes sense.
Wow, I didn't see that coming.
If you're right, that means we can open the box.
Yeah, awesome.
Thank you.